Just wait till you drive.
It's quite trippy because these little things start to move.
November 27th is our general election for people like Mike Hosking, Paul Holmes, George Kerbal, and Linda Clark. This is where it all erupts into madness. From then on, we pick it apart piece by piece. We decide whether we've made a good decision as a country or a bad decision. It's the decision 99. But for some people, November 27th will be an uncomfortable, sad day.
For the people who lose, it's a slow walk back down the hall into their office and tidy up their stuff and move out.
Time to get a real job. But what about the people who are at the bottom of the party list? What about the people who in the old days would have been called Young Labour or Young Nats? Nowadays, are just called bottom old, bottom of the list, bottom olds. What about them? Let's meet one. Let's meet Mr. Lucky. We're going to meet a man called Jani Johansson. Jani, and we're not joking, is the number 63 member on the Labour Party list. He's a list party potential MP for the Labour Party.
We thought it would be a nice idea to get some party candidates and ask them some questions in the mastermind style.
Unfortunately, all of the candidates, all of the politicians, current and up and coming, wouldn't take the test unless we fax them out the questions beforehand. And frankly, that's not in the style of the game, is it?
Look, it's Jesse the Body Ventura and Vince McMahon, and that's Jimmy Superfly Snooker, looks like Winston Peters.
Does a list MP have what it takes to know what the people want? Will he know what we're asking for on November 27th? This is Jani Johansson, number 63 on the Labour Party list. Jani? Let's see if you've got the goods.
Jani Johansson, your specialist subject is mid-90s gangster rap. You have 2 minutes to answer as many questions as you can on that topic, and your time starts now. Who is the male presenter of Caltech's Dreams Come True?
Pass.
What is the Christian name of Jenny Shipley's partner, Burton?
Burton.
Correct. What is the street value of an E?
$100.
Correct. How do you spell Siobhan?
S-I-O-B-A-H-N.
Correct. Who got fourth place and will have to qualify for the 2003 Rugby World Cup for the first time in history?
The All Blacks.
Correct. Name the four members of UK number one pop sensation S Club 7.
Pass.
Name the swear word starting with an F and rhyming with tuck.
Fuck.
Complete the sentence. I've got the poison, I've got the remedy.
Pass.
Spell Confasa.
C-O-N-F-A-R-C-E-A.
No, I'm sorry, that's incorrect. What South Island town has the highest gay population per capita in the South Island?
Gore.
Correct. Which TV celebrity had to destroy her dogs after they savaged some sheep?
Suzanne Paul.
No, incorrect. Name the red-faced character who personified pure, concentrated evil in Star Wars Episode 1.
Pass.
On which Kiss album would you find Detroit Rock City?
Pass.
Place the nickname with the correct political journalist. Paul Holmes, Jane Young, Leah Panapa are the journalists. The nicknames are The Pineapple, The Little Maestro, Come Down My Selector, Boomster Batster, Boomster Batster, Boom.
Paul Holmes, Little Maestro. Jane Young, Come Down My Boomster, Bumster, Boom. Leanne Panapa, Pineapple.
Correct. What's Fatboy Slim's real name?
Pass.
Finish the sentence, Jim.
Beam me up, Jim.
Incorrect. Who was the leader of the Federated Farmers Federation in 1976?
Robert Muldoon.
Incorrect. Who plays Auckland's hottest music?
BFM.
Incorrect. Name one river flowing through the city of Christchurch.
The Avon.
Correct. Who was the Green Party candidate for Coromandel?
Jeanette Fitzsimons.
Correct. Who was Razzo's alien co-host in the wacky offbeat TV3 comedy series Off the Planet?
Pass.
Which cricketer debuted against... I've started the question, so I will finish. Which cricketer debuted against Australia at Eden Park with figures of 2 for 37?
Craig McMillan.
Incorrect.
Daniel Johansson, you passed on 8 and answered 6 questions incorrectly. I'm going to run through those for you now. Who is the male presenter of Celtic's Dreams Come True? The answer, of course, is Nick Enyan. Name the 4 members of UK pop sensation S Club 7. The answers are Tina, Paul, Hannah, John, Bradley, Joe and Rachel. You could have chosen 4 of those. Complete the sentence. I've got the poison, I've got the remedy, I've got the, of course it was pulsating rhythmical remedy.
Chemical Brothers.
Which TV celebrity had to destroy her dogs after they savaged some sheep? Of course, we'll all remember that incident. That was Jude Dobson. And name the red-faced character who personified pure concentrated evil in Star Wars Episode 1. And Star Wars fans will know that that's Darth Maul. On which Kiss album would you find Detroit Rock City? And the answer to that is Double Platinum. What's Fatboy Slim's real name? Norman Cook. Finish the sentence, Jim. And of course our viewers will know that's Knox, Jim Knox. Who was the leader of the Federated Farmers in 1976? Quite a tough question, that one, but that was, again, Jim Knox. And third to last was, who plays Auckland's hottest music? And the answer is MyFM 88.6, but I would have taken Classic Hits 91ZM. The second to last one was, who was Razzo's alien co-host of the wacky offbeat TV3 comedy series Off the Planet? Quite a difficult one, that one. That was Nick Enyan. And finally, which cricketer debuted against Australia at Eden Park with figures of 237? And cricketing fans will know that's Stu Gillespie. So to reiterate, Yanni passed on 8, 6 incorrect, and a final total of 8.
Three gerbils and a toothbrush. Of course, Yanni was the only contestant in our Mastermind Challenge, but he did take out the prize because he was the only one. So, of course, we've got a prize to give him, and that's a Breville Forgettle. I'll just put that in my mouth. Excuse me, Yanni. Congratulations. Well done.
But like every election, there's a winner and a loser. And since you're also the loser, Yanni, news to you by the guitar-shaped pool.
Yanni, seeing as you're the only contestant, you're not only the winner, but you're also the loser. Which means, as you know, we're going to pull your pants down and push you in the pool.